Hello everyone, welcome to my stream. This is the stream of Friday about AmigaOS. Let me lower a little bit the volume. Yeah, I hope you can hear me well. Welcome, I'm George. You can find me as Volquero in various Amiga forums. Please tell me if the sound is good and if the screen, the image is fine. Hello SLT Snake, welcome to the stream. Today is Christmas Eve, right? So we are going to have a different stream. Today I plan to have a look on the Christmas gift that Hyperion and the developers of AmigaOS OS 3.2 gave us, which is the latest update, the 3.2.1. We will start with that. We will see how this is working and how we can update our installation of AmigaOS 3.2, and also what are some key features that they introduced or fixed in the new version, in the new update. And after that, we are going to have fun with a few games for different platforms. We are going to see games from Commodore 64, Amiga, AmigaOS 4, and possible a game from Super Nintendo. We will see. And everything, we are going to run them on the AmigaOS 4 system. Let me close this first. And yeah, 3.2, yes, 0.1. Yes, SLT Snake, we are going to have fun with this one. And ICOMP also published a new version of Picasso 96, which is 3.2.0, right? So the numbering is pretty close. I hope that it doesn't confuse anyone. First of all, let's have a look on Hyperion website. So here we see that AmigaOS 3.2.1 update is available since 2 days ago, 3 days ago. And everyone who is who bought AmigaOS 3.2, they have a serial number which they use to register their copy at the website. And as soon as they do that, they are going to be able to download the LHA archive with the update, which I have already here. And of course, to register your copy, your serial number of the AmigaOS 3.2, you have to log in at the website of Hyperion, register your copy, and get the download. So I'm going to do the update on the emulated AmigaOS 3.2 that I have shown you before. I have here a folder where I have the AmigaOS 3.2. I have here a hard disk file with the installation. Let me start it. And let me do that full screen. So right now you see the screen is a little bit stretched because of my scaler. Actually, on AmigaOS 4, the resolution is 640 to 512, which is 4:3 ratio. And it shows pretty fine, but because of my scaler that I have here, you see that stretched. So I have here the installation of AmigaOS 3.2, and SLT Snake says, I was earlier updating my Amithron Sys and the ROM file. Okay, it works fine there with Amithron. Or did you have any issues? So what I have to do here is, here I have a shared folder with the rest of the AmigaOS 4, and I have the update here, which I can't double click because I don't have a default application, but I will open a shell and do LHAX, drag and drop the AmigaOS 3.2.1 update and point it to RAM. Everything fine, eh? Hello, Livelord. Welcome to the stream. Thank you very much for joining. We are going to see the update, the Christmas gift that Hyperion and the developers of AmigaOS 3.2 gave us just a few days before Christmas. And since it is Christmas Eve today, we are going to have a special stream, different from the rest, from the previous ones. We are going to see the update for AmigaOS 3.2, and then we are going to have some Christmas games. So I extracted the update. We have here a folder in RAM, and let me see information. Yeah, the update is around 32 megabytes of files. Okay, so plenty of things changed. There is some information here how to install it, but we are going to see all the steps right now, and a summary of all the changes. We are going to have a look on a few of them, and let's start the update. The first thing that you need to do is go to ADFs and mount the update 3.2.1 ADF file, the image for the disk. Click install, select the installer based on your language. For the Greek, don't worry, you are not going to have any problems, because although it's for Greek, all the texts are in English. This the installer was not translated. Yeah, Livelord, it's about 3.2.1, but running on AmigaOS 4, because we are going to see different things today. Yeah, it was a beautiful present, Livelord, you're right. And to be honest, I didn't expect it to be released so soon. I had that because I'm a beta tester and translator for the Greek language. So I was following the update and the new things that were coming. Let's continue the installation, proceed. Update 3.2.1 will now be installed on your hard drive. Okay, any previous release will be replaced. Do you want update 3.2.1 installed? Yes. Here, if you don't want for that to be installed in that partition, you have to click on no, and then the installer is going to ask you exactly for which partition it's going to use and where to install the update. For me, it's fine because I have only one partition here, so it is quite well. Yes, I will choose Greek as well. So the new update is going to update the startup sequence. The startup sequence, we have discussed about that file before. It's the first script that is executed when you start, when you boot your AmigaOS. So because it does some changes there, and creates a new startup sequence. It stores the previous one in a folder named old under your partition, your installation partition. That's where you can find it in case you have some issues. For example, if you have hardware like fast data or something else that needs to install specific devices there, you have to go to the previous file and see what changes, what you need to load by default, so that you are not going to have issues with your installation. So I'm going to click move. It's recommended to keep that copy, because in case you have issues, you can find what you had on your previous, before the update. So right now it goes with installation. As you can see at the left side, it mounts automatically all the needed ADF files, the ADF image files for the floppies, so you don't have to do it manually. Okay, and you can relax, drink some tea or coffee. Please identify your hardware module. For me is a 1200. The installation of update 3.2.1 is now complete. We have to reboot. Have in mind, in this installation there are some new ROMs which you can use to, if you run your Amiga on an emulated environment like me right now, I can easily use the new version of the ROM, right? On the classic hardware, you can contact your reseller if he is going to sell newer versions, although that the developers do not recommend to do that. And if it is possible to use the new ROMs with a kick ROM, based on if your hardware supports it, it is better to go that way. Because for the next versions, they say that they probably are going to make even more changes on the ROM, so they are going to release a newer version, so you don't have to buy new ROM modules all the time. SLD Snake says, I have some patches at the startup sequence, so I needed to manually edit after installation. Yes. The level says the same here for fast data. Exactly. So if, because I read somewhere on forums, I think that people with fast data had issues that they didn't accept, or the second IDE didn't work. That's the reason. You need to check again the startup sequence if it has everything in there as it, the previous one had. Livelord says, wondering how the existing patches will work with this update, like AlphaOS, Birdie and similar. We can investigate it further if you want on the next stream. We can do that. If you remember, I have an installation with all this stuff. I know that applications that were looking for the execute command in C, if you remember, one of the wsdload launcher that we used before in one of my older streams was looking for that file, and it was not working well with AmigaOS 3.2. Now the execute is under C folder, so this is something that will make all these applications work. I haven't heard, but I didn't try that yet, any issues with the AlphaOS and the Birdie, the things that we used before to make our AmigaOS 3.2 look better on RTG systems. But we can have a look on that if you want. So let me proceed with the reset. And since it is emulated Amiga, I don't have to remove any floppy. Let's see how this goes about. So I still have the old ROM, the 3.2, and the release is 3.2.1. Let's have a look on a few updates and changes that they introduced with this update, right? Livelo says, all I can say is we'll wait on next time. Thank you, George. Thank you, Livelo, for being so loyal to my streams. Thank you very much for being here. My beloved, new feature. You know from the new version of AmigaOS 3.2 that when you have a shell, right, you can drag and drop anything you want into the shell. You will see here that you probably saw that already, that as soon as I dragged and dropped something in there, let's say this one, the shell remains active. This is so crucial, because if you are doing something, especially when you extract files with LHAX something, and then you lose the focus from the shell, it is crucial, because you have to reach your mouse again and click on the window. Right now we can do exactly drag and drop the archive there, sorry, like that, and the shell remains active. For me, it's one of the most useful changes. It seems little, small change, but it is pretty useful. One of the other changes that I would like to show you is the show config. If you remember, the show config since AmigaOS 3.2 changed, and it has its own window. And right now, it doesn't only show you some information, some basic information about the hardware, but also it shows you the devices that are mounted, the libraries that are already loaded, the resources that are occupied. So you can have a full idea of what is running on your computer right now, and find everything that might break something on your system. For example, you can have a look here, the console device, which version it is exactly. So if you have some issues and you want to know if you loaded the right console device, this is the place to go. Or the amount of memory that your computer has. And if it is fast memory, fast RAM, or anything else. Residents, devices and libraries that are stored, that are loaded as residents on your system, and they remain in RAM. And yeah, the resources and the drives that are loaded, okay, and the device that they are using. And also here you can find a new menu item that is for generating a report about your hardware. There are two ways, two formats that you can export this report, Amiga Guide and text. I will select Amiga Guide for the test, and we'll save it in RAM here. And let's say report.amigaguide or guide, much better. Okay, generate. You can select here which components you want to include in this report. Generate, report has been written. Okay, let me close that and let's have a look on that. So all files, report guide, and here we have the report for our hardware in an Amiga guide file, which you can share with anyone you would like to share it with. It is useful, especially if you reporting a bug that you might found on the hardware or on the software, on the AmigaOS or something else, and the user, the developer asks you for the hardware, what type of hardware you have, what you're running, and things like that. SLD Snake says, oh, I missed that export option when I upgraded the system. Yeah, it is quite useful, and you can also do that from the cell if you want. Exporting to Amiga Guide. Yeah, and it is a perfect Amiga Guide with all the information there. So if something is not working for you, hello, Creevy, welcome to the stream. If something doesn't work for you, for example, let's say that you try to run a game and it doesn't work because some library is missing or anything, and the developer says, what are you running on your system? What kind of system you have? And things like that. And you can send something like this Amiga Guide with all the information. It doesn't have any personal information, so if you worry about that, so it's not something that people are going to use to track you. Libero says, that's nice, exporting to Amiga Guide. I have read about the future, and it looks awesome. Yeah, exactly. Only thing regarding the Amiga Guide is that you can't search for text, or I am not aware how. Yeah, the find is not enabled because we loaded that from multiview. Yeah, you can't search, that's right. But what you can do is go to text edit, open the Amiga Guide file, which is a text file, right, and search here for anything you want. Like that. So you can find something here. If the Amiga Guide is big, for example, the help Amiga Guide of AmigaOS 3.2 is quite big. So if you try to find something, I always do this thing, because a guide file is just a plain text with a good way to look with some, let's say, tag text that help the Amiga Guide to be shown the way it is. Libero says, I just wish there is a feature within Amiga Guide. I think it's not a thing of the Amiga Guide, the defined. It has to do with the viewer of that you use. I believe there were other viewers that you have the ability to search for something in the Amiga Guide page, but I'm not sure which one. I'm going to look about that and let you know. So, TextEdit also had a lot of bug fixes, and also they introduced another export to TextEdit. So, it has another export for every opened file that you might have. So, with Rx, if you use Rx, you can talk to the TextEdit program, and especially on specific files that are open, and do stuff. Libelo says, I'll check the other viewers. Thanks. You're welcome. I will check that as well, and we can share the knowledge on the next stream. What else? Icon Edit got a big upgrade where you can there were a few new features here, and also bug fixes. You can see that you can have a lot of colors where you can use, which you can use to draw your icons. Okay, and you can zoom as well. If you want to create icons with icon edit. Another cool feature is the eject. If you go here at the top of the menu, it is great right now, but it says eject disk. Let's see how it works. If we open here, let me create a new cell. Great. LHAX. To RAM. Okay, let's extract that because it has a few ADF files in there, a lot of ADF files actually. So if you mount an ADF, like let's say this one, okay, and this one, so I have two mounted ADF files here, and you want to remove them, if you remember. With AmigaOS 3.2, you have to use the DA control and unmount these two mounted images of the floppies. So right now with the update, after the update, you can select them and go here and eject those disks like that, and they are going to be removed. And also with this inject, if you have a CD-ROM attached to your Amiga, probably it will be supported. It depends on the CD-ROM and how it communicates with the Amiga of your Amiga. And when you select the icon of the CD and click on inject, it's going to open the tray and spits out the CD-ROM. That's why eject is there, and yeah, it is quite useful. If you remember also, there were a couple of solutions to do that for the ADF files on Aminet. We have seen one of them on previous streams. Right now it's in the operating system, which is much more convenient, and it works great. And what else? One last thing that I wanted to show you is that the list browser, which is this object here, this component, has right now ordering. So you can click at the top of the title of each column and order the results based on that. And if you click once, it is incremental, and if you click it again, it will reverse the order. Quite useful if you want to sort things. For example, if you want to go, let's say, to here on Residence, and sort them based on the version. You can do that by clicking one time here on the first title, and it sorts everything based on the version. That's also a good change, because this is something that that you are going to have on your applications. If you create something with if you create an application with using the reaction, so if someone develops a new application that uses these list browsers, he automatically gets that feature as well. He doesn't need to build it on his own. That's pretty much the updates, the changes that you can see on your new updated AmigaOS 3.2.1. Of course, there are a lot of changes, bug fixes that people reported to the development team of AmigaOS 3.2, and they created those fixes. I will say, read this change summary, because all the information about all these changes are here, and you can understand what changed better and have the ability to know that if that change influences you or not, or if you need to make to change something on your hardware, and I mean on your drivers and things like that, not remove something from the hardware because of the update. So about the ROMs, as I told you, the developers recommend to not buy or create. If you have your own burner for ROMs, go ahead and create your own ROMs, or if you have a friend to do that for you. But they are recommending that you can use the ROMs with the Keychron abilities of your hardware, if it has something like that, and you can load the Keychrons, the ROMs like that. Also, one more change that comes with these new ROMs is that if you don't have, for some reason, you don't have any device attached on your Amiga that the system can boot from, not any hard disk or floppy or whatever, the boot ROM image is going to flash red, so you are not you can understand that that's the reason that nothing is happening and that it doesn't find any device to use to boot from. Liberal says, do we have to use Kick ROM? Can I just stay? You can stay with 3.2, absolutely. Yes. As you can see here, it is 3.2 ROM. I didn't use the updated one. I have a map ROM at Amiga 1200, but maybe I can erase and reprogram my 3000 or 4000 3.2 EEPROMs. If you have SLD Snake, something like that, if you have a burner for the ROMs, you can do that. Erase the previous ones and update them with a new one. If you use map ROM, then to load the newer ROM, then you might introduce on your system a second reboot of your when you first boot from cold boot. Okay, so if you don't want to have that, but you want to use the latest ROM, you have to create a new ROM 3.2.1. And if you have the hardware to burn your own ROMs, that's the best thing to do. But you can continue using the 3.2 ROMs just fine, without any issues. If I'm not wrong, if you use the 3.2 ROMs, the extra changes are loaded from the hard disk. That's the only thing. Otherwise, you don't have any problems. Anything else that you would like to ask about this update? The update process is quite straightforward. It's not a problem. There's no problems with that. So, and I don't think that, as you have seen, it is quite easy for anyone to do. Let me close the AmigaOS 3.2 right now. And return to AmigaOS 4. And see what we have next. Since it is Christmas Eve today, right? I thought to play some Christmas games, but they are not going only to be Amiga games. I have some of them, but we are going to see some other games from Commodore 64 And Amiga OS 4 as well. SLDs Nexus, it's more or less like 3.1.4.1 upgrade. The workbench load the new modules via software. Exactly. So no new ROM are mandatory. Exactly. The only thing that I haven't tried yet is to use 3.1 ROMs and have an installation of 3.2 based on them and to do the update. To be honest, you know, run 3.2.1 AmigaOS with 3.1 ROMs. Since 3.2 AmigaOS was working fine with these ROMs, I don't expect that there are going to be any issues with the updated AmigaOS. So I prepared the an iGame installation with some games that are Christmas games. Okay, I have a few there here. We don't have to see all of them because I have a couple others to show you as well. But let's have a look how they are working on AmigaOS 4. Let's start with the first one, the Fire and Ice Xmas demo. I'm using here my beloved joystick. This is a custom-made joystick with four buttons. It is going with a USB cable to the Amiga One, and it's quite heavy and strong. Let's see. So right now I have iGame, and I added there the games with the screenshots that I would like. This one is a classic Amiga 68K game, right? Like, and this one as well. And I have the Lemmings, but I have also Santron to show you, which is a shoot 'em up for Commodore 64, and it runs with the Vice emulator. And I have also to show you the Snow Force, which was released a couple of days ago for Commodore 64 by Sarah Jane Avery. And it's a brand new game as well. Actually, it's a remake of the Soul Force, another shoot 'em up for Amiga for Commodore 64. Let's start with this one. What do you say? That's one robust joystick. Yeah. That's that joystick. I have it for 5 years. And I never had to change any switch. It's working perfectly. So I'm double clicking on the game here, and the emulator starts automatically and loads the CRT file. What I actually have done for this is I have an emulator folder here. I have the game in its own folder, and I have a script that gets the executable, the emulator, and loads the CRT, and it says auto start, just this line. And then I give that script to iGame. And I forgot to show you, I have here an iGame IFF file. That's the screenshot that you can see at the side. So you can use it to load whatever you want from games, from any emulator system. Let's start with that. I will make it bigger, although that it will be a little bit stretched for you. So, Snow Force is a remake that is for the Christmas period. Okay, Sarah Jane always do something like that with her games, especially the shoot'em ups like this one. She creates new graphics for the Christmas period, and she releases that. This game is based on Soulforce, one of the shoot 'em ups that she released, I think, a year ago. And there is also a new mode here, Soulforce X, which I haven't run it yet, but we will see if we can have a look. Snowfalls, start the game. It has some, before each stage, it has some information about the story, navigation systems online, all weapon systems ready. Engines at full power, let's go for launch. So we have this slate here. Hope you have a sound at your speakers. Sarah creates a very lovely games for Commodore 64. Recently she released a game called the Briley Chronicles, something like that, which is a very nice game as well. And she creates she creates that for Amiga as well. So we can see her releasing Amiga games in the future. I don't know if you like playing games from Commodore 64 at all, or if anyone has a Commodore or uses a Commodore as well. So this is the first boss. Of course, I don't recommend anyone to get such a system like the Amiga 1X 5000 just to play the Commodore 64 games. The new games that Sarah is releasing always are able to play them on the C64 that was released. Either the Mini or the Maxi one with the real keyboard. So if you have one of them, it is better to buy that for playing games, Commodore 64 games. But for me, since I have that here and the emulator is working quite well, I use that for all the Commodore 64 games. Liberal says, I need to install some games on my Amiga and check iGame, it looks fun. Yeah, iGame is very nice, and I'm saying that not because I'm involved on the development, because I use it a lot, and you can, the AmigaOS 4 version is a native one, and you can use it on AmigaOS 3 as well, and Morphos. Aris Amiga, welcome to the stream, this game is amazing. Yeah, it is, and it has some good music, right? Liverpool says that would be way too expensive to have an X5000 for the Commodore 64 games, right? It's an expensive Commodore 64. The Greenskins have constructed a base deep underground. Go in there and destroy the base. Sir, sensors have detected the entrance. I'll engage the surface enemies before entering the base. Good luck, Captain. We are all depending on you. So we have to destroy everything. Soul Force is more than 16 stages, if I remember correct. So it's quite big game. We are not going to try to finish it today, of course. And the good thing is that this game has some power-ups for your ship or slate here, and it's quite well made. And also it has a continuous. If you lose all your lives, if you have seen the game over, then you have you get after each stage a code which you can use to continue your game from this stage. The response is quite well here on this emulator, and it's quite fun. When I was playing the Soul Force, I was so addicted until I didn't get up from my seat until I finished it, and it's very nice. As you can see, there is some parallax at the background. And one last thing that I would like to tell you is that we have one more boss here. So this game right now, it's available on the itch.io website of Sarah Jane Avery, and she's selling that. It's something less than 2 euros because it is 50% sale right now. So I would recommend you, if you would like to have this game, to go and buy it and support her for the future releases and development. So as you can see here, it's the password at the bottom, which you can save. I usually take my mobile and take a photo of that, so I can have the latest password. Leveler says you have some gaming skill. Not really. And here it is also saved to disk. You can save it if you want, so to continue another day. Let me close it for now, this one, and move on to the next one. One of my beloved games for Amiga is Santa's Xmas Caper. Unfortunately, it has some issues here on the emulator, on UI. Let me make it big. Not that it doesn't work well. Actually, it's loading just fine, and it's everything is fine. But it seems that this game is not well made for fast Amigas, or something else is happening, because it's way fast. Way faster than what I remember from my 1200. And it's a very nice little game because it has just a few stages. And I tried a lot to make it work well. Right now I have it without JIT enabled. I have that configured that the CPU type is 68040, for example, and the speed is the real of the machine, and still it is quite fast, and I don't have any frame skipping. You are going to see this in a moment, because this is a platform game, and you have to have an accurate timing on this kind of games. As you can see, it's quite fast. But if you have to, if you have the ability to run it on a real hardware, it's a very nice game for classic Amigas. In this game, you don't kill anything because you are Santa, of course. But everything is killing you. What you have to do is to freeze all the enemies, and then gather all the presents for the kids, right? Game over. And some time ago I finished that game, which is not a big achievement, but I have played that before, so it's not quite playable on this emulator, unfortunately. Until I find something better to make it slower. The music is very, very nice. I don't know if this is easy for you to see, but the nose of Santa is quite red, so I don't know if that means that he was drinking before. Very red as a listener, yes. It reminds me a little bit of James Bond. I don't know if I'm right on that. Which games are you playing, guys, on these days on your Amigas? Feel free to write down That Christmas tree is amazing, right? And of course we have penguins as well. Yeah, Christmas. Missing one gift somewhere. Where I forgot one gift. Ah, here it is. And that's my last life. So I have to be a little bit careful. Oh my god. Libelo says Defteros is for me trying to finish it since it came out. Man, that game is so weird and so tough. Just don't have enough time for it. Yes. After that, planning to give a shot to Warhead. I haven't heard about that game. SLD Snake says, I'm not playing Amiga games these days, I'm not a good example. No, not at all? Not even the Xmas Santa games? JMA 80, welcome to the stream! Welcome, man! Played some Turbo Santa lately. Very nice game, I have it here. New game from Nivrik. Right? John Girvin. Very nice game. Which is... the Turbo Santa is able to... for someone to buy it from his itch.io page. People says it's a space fighting sim. The Warhead, eh? Mm. SLD Snake, some Xbox One for me, not retro. SLD Snake, any recommendations? Feel free to write at the chat. this game has a very nice music, to be honest. I keep it a little bit more because of the music. Nobby the Penguin. If you haven't played that game, the Santa's Xmas Caper, totally recommended. And I will find a way to make it work, the timing to make it right. So the next one game is going to be an AmigaOS 4 game. The only one that I have right now for you to show you. It's a game that was released back in 2015, and it was mostly a concept game to test the abilities of the Amiga OS 4 with high resolution graphics and PNG images and things like that. It's quite simple. You have Santa, who is shooting a lot of zombies and monsters. You have the ability to change guns and buy new guns. If you see at the top, you have a number of let me lower the sound. God. So right now I have the shotgun. At the top you have some time that counts down, and if you finish the stage before the time ends, then you get some extra money. And the target for this game is, as I said, it was a concept game. It was not a full game for AmigaOS 4, and the target is to kill anything that moves. I like the way that Santa is looking, and if you like to play a game just to kill some time, it's available free of charge for AmigaOS 4. This was developed by Entwickler X team, who gave us a lot of other very nice games like Maze, the shoot 'em up, and also the Swap Defense. And these guys are creating games for other systems as well, for Switch and mobiles. If you find their games, it's good to support them. If you like them and like the games and would like to buy something like that. It's a little bit brutal. Having Santa killing everything, in his way. The nice thing about this game is the awesome graphics, and how good they are working on AmigaOS 4. If this existed on AmigaOS 3, then probably you would need something like a vampire to play that. And I think that the vampire team has created something similar games just to show the capabilities of the hardware. Sylvan Snake says, whoa, zombies. The zombie games that I remember is Zombie Apocalypse. Very nice game that you use the mouse to shoot the zombies that are coming towards you, right? JMA80 says, Santa's Monster shout out. Played this when it came out. Yes, yes, I remember that game when it came out. It was really fun. Graphics are awesome, says Livelord. Music as well. Yeah, the shouts at the back is quite well done. So if you manage to gather a lot of money, you can buy extra guns and have further fun with the zombies, right? JMA says, if these guys are still developing games, a lot of games. They released the last one that they released for Amiga OS 4, it was Spencer, a platform game, a 3D platform game. And right now they are developing mostly for Switch and other consoles, game consoles. I think they are developing for the latest games for PS5 as well. And I saw that they are in the middle of development for a game that looks like Spencer. It's also a platform that you have to solve some go from platform to platform and solve some puzzles and open doors and gather stuff. I wish they had some more time to create games for Amigos 4, but I understand that they have to buy food for their families, so they have to support mostly platforms that have much more buyers. From my side, I try to support them as much as I can, and I buy, even for the other platforms, I buy the games. Also, every game they release is available on PC, so you can find it there as well. It's not that fun like this one, but in which other game you have Santa killing zombies, right? In which other game you have Santa with a shotgun? And this game looks pretty good on if you run it in full screen. Let me show you just a few seconds. I have that here. Full screen. Which is 1080p. Right? So so that's our Santa killing zombies. JMA says, never tried Spencer, need check it out. Spencer is... let me find it. Spencer is a very nice game. Which uses all the newest technology for AmigaOS 4 on graphics. Uh, It's completely 3D. Let me see the keys. Okay. You can find it on Windows as well. It's not an Xmas game, but it's quite fun. And the what you need to do here is to finish all the stages, getting all the gems without losing. And the best thing to do is also to not lose any life, because you, by doing that, you get more money, points. Sorry. And this is a ghost that you can't kill and hunts you all the time, like the right, like what the right ghosts are doing, right? So you will say that this is a platform puzzle game. And this is Spencer. But let's get back to the Christmas theme games. Okay, let's see something from Commodore 64 again. Santron. Santron is one more shoot 'em up created by Sarah Jane Avery, and before that she created a game called Neutron, and based on that she changed the music and the graphics to be themed like for Christmas. This one is different, like the previous one, because it is a vertical scrolling shoot 'em up. You can find this game as well on the itch.io page of Sarah Jane Avery, and actually you can buy it. You can get it free of charge, because you can name your own price if you want, or download it with no money at all if you want to try this out. And if you like it, you can buy it later. Libero says, while we're talking games, is Free Space from Hyperion working out of the box for AmigaOS 4.1? Or you need to fiddle around to play it? From the last update that was released some time ago, if I remember correct, you don't need to do any anything. You just run it, and it's working just fine. Are you guys play shoot 'em ups at all, or which is your beloved genre of games? What you prefer to play? For Commodore 64, Commodore 64 was, I believe, famous for its shoot 'em ups, right? It's one of the type of games that look pretty good on Commodore 64, in my opinion. Strategy and any kind of sim games. That's very nice games, Liberlord, but the problem that I have with this kind of games is that you have to remember where you left the game, and usually I have I don't have so much time to play. I might play once per week, and I don't remember what I have to do. So I prefer games that do not have so much of story behind, or something that I can start quite fast and play with that. So the best games for me are first-person shooters, and shoot 'em ups. JMA says, I wasn't shoot 'em up guy back in the day, but now I really like them. Yeah, I like them because I can start playing them at any time. It's quite convenient. Oh my god, it has auto fire. Great. Awesome. As you can see, you can play Commodore 64 games quite well. Although I said, as I said before, I do not recommend to buy an X5000 just to play Commodore 64 games. But if you want to play them, they are there. The emulator works pretty well. I just want to test the latest release for Commodore 64 of Sonic the Hedgehog that was released a couple of days ago as well. I haven't tested that on this emulator, this version, and I want to see how it works because it's using an extra hardware, the REU memory module that is emulated, and I want to see if it works well. So the other game that Sarah Jane have already released a couple of months ago is Brille Witch Chronicles, which is a very nice game, and I recommend you if you are if you like to play games that are like Zelda, the old Zelda games, a little bit of RPG with a story, a good story, check this out. It's a very nice game for Commodore 64. And she's developing a version, the second part of this game as well, and she's testing to make an Amiga version for this. JMA says Nvidia and Reshooter are great. Reshooter is one of my beloved Amiga shoot 'em up games, the new versions one, the newer ones, right? SLT Snake says I played mostly at consoles, but I like mainly adventures like Resident Evil and Metal Gear. Resident Evil is one of my beloved, as well as Silent Hill. I mostly remember from PlayStation era. I remember less the 8/16-bit era. Okay. So you didn't have the 8-bit and 16-bit consoles before that, before the PlayStation. So right now I would like to show you the Sandarox. This is also an older game from Nivrig. Let me make it full screen. This is the Christmas version of Dodgy Rocks. Dodgy Rocks was one of the games that Nivrig released, I think, back in 2019. And then he created the Christmas version, which is Sandarox. Here you have the Santa at the bottom of the screen, and you have to avoid all the snowballs that this guy is snowing at the top on you, and you get some points if you dodge them. Or if you can also move fast at the top or at the side to break those snowballs. So the target for this game is to survive as much as possible and gather as many points as you can. Aris Amiga spent so many time on that, this game, right, Aris? SLD Snake says, I had the Super NES 16-bit, but maybe my memory is getting weak and I have less memories about that. Probably PlayStation, the reason is that PlayStation was way better than the Super NES, right? And the games were awesome. So it is logical that your memory deleted anything that had to do with the Super NES. The Commodore 64 seems to have an awesome scene. It is. It has so many games. Every month a new game is released. Almost every month. Aris Amiga says, haha, don't even remind me. Hello, Amiga Gamer. Welcome to the stream. Happy holidays to you as well. Yeah. Aris Amiga had some good memories from this kind of game. Dodgy Rocks, as well as Santa Rocks, is quite well done game. It's of these games, the simple games that you can start whenever you want and spend some good time with it. It has some strategy as well. And the game starts slow at the beginning, but it gets quite fast later. At the top, at the middle, you have the multiplier. You have to, if you want to make a high score, you have to keep it as much as bigger as possible. And you can do that by dodging all the balls at the last minute, second, and or break them by moving at the side or at the top. Amiga Gamer says, today Snow Force is released on Commodore 64 and CSDB Nostalgia have remastered all the SSI gold boxes on to cartridge. Yes, big Commodore 64 scene. Actually, Amiga Gamer, I don't know if you missed that. We played Snow Force a few minutes ago. It's a very nice game. I have the Soul Force, which is the game that Snow Force was based on, and from my experience it's an awesome game from Sarah. I totally recommend it for anyone. JMA says, simple but addictive. It's nice to have online high score tables in these games. Yeah, it's you see, I can make bigger scores. You see the top scores of 2,400. It's not what you see right now. I have so much time to play. Yeah, the online scores expands the game on the time, right? You play that more just to pass the scores from the other players. Amiga Gamer says, George, you need to put a Turbo Santa score on the leaderboard of Niverick site. Amiga Gamer, you are right. I avoided to play this game because it is all this fast movement makes me quite anxious, to be honest. But I'm going to try that in a few minutes. Aris Amiga says, oh yeah, isn't there like a competition for the Turbo Santa? Is there a competition? I don't know. SLD Snake says, I remember an Amiga format covering a report about the new PowerPC CPU, and they were questioning something like, what games would like next? Resident Evil, Silent Hill, etc. They never came. Yeah. There was a game for Amiga that it was a demo mostly, or a proof of concept, that had graphics like Resident Evil with the mist and things like that. I believe you can find it on Aminet, and it of course required a pretty fast CPU, but it never was completed. Mika Gamer, oh, I just got there about 10 minutes ago. Soulforce is free with Snowforce. Exactly. The Soulforce X, that is an option inside Snowforce, that's the that's the one, Amiga Gamer, because I have seen that on in the options, but I thought that it was a different mode for Snowforce. I don't know if this is the complete game. JMA says, yeah, top 3 score wins. That would be quite hard for me to get in there. Amiga Gamer says, yes, it's very fast. It is very fast. But let's have a look on that. Let me quit this one and go to Turbo Santa. Again, sorry that this the screen that you see is stressed. That's because of my scaler. Okay, is the music okay or too loud? Please tell me. Thanks, Aris Amiga. Thank you for your help. SLD Snake says, I will have to take a look on at Aminet. The only one from PlayStation Market that I remember is Wipeout, which was released, right, SLD Snake? That's the only one that it was released at the end. Yeah, I don't think that there were any plans to port Silent Hill, to be honest. So let's see what we can do with Turbo Santa. You have Santa, collect gifts and give them to the children. Be quick, don't miss. Beware the grunts. Push button. Okay. Deliver 6 presents before time runs out. Okay, let me try that. I'm lousy on this game already. But in my defense, it's the first time that I played. Whoa! Okay, Deliver 8 presents before time runs out. Okay. Aris Amiga says that timer though, that's fast. Yeah, it is. New high score for me. Yeah. 7,749. Tell me, Amiga Gamer, what's the high score on the contest? How close am I? I guess not even close, not in the first 10 places, right? Have to practice more. But it's a very nice, clever game. 5,600. Oh my god. 569,655. Not even close. To get the 10th, you'd need to get to level 16. Oh my god. What? I agree with Aris Amiga. I wasn't able to finish the first wave when I played it. I got 70,000 at level 13, so there must be tricks to high score bonuses. I guess you have to gather all the things that the kids drop to you. Maybe these are pennies over there or something, I don't know. And these are giving you some extra score. SLD Snake says, I took a look at the X5000, but wow, I wasn't ready to see the price. Ah, for the X5000 hardware, you mean a complete system, SLD Snake? With a tower and the graphics card and all the stuff? Or just the motherboard? Amiga Gamer says, you really have to be in the mood of it, for it, Aris Amiga. I couldn't beat level 2 today. I don't think I enjoy games like this for a short time. Then remind myself I prefer strategy and RPG. Amiga Gamer, I agree with you. I'm like that as well. I am too slow. Me too. TMA says, a trick is to not lose presents as it will reset your score multiplier. Oh, it has? Okay. It has a multiplier. That's the thing that Nivrik likes to do. It's exactly the same thing like he did with the Dodgy Rocks. JMA, that's where I went wrong then. I just smabbed them. Me too, as you have clearly seen, right? Not another multiplayer. I agree with you, Aris Amiga. I agree with you. Let's see how we will not go right now. What can you do if they change all the time direction? Now it's much better. And still I miss them. $24,000. That's good. Wave 6. That's fine for me. SLD Snake says, yes, the complete system, because I think there's no motherboard only option, if I'm not mistaken. Well, the tabor, but in progress. The tabor will be a very good system when this is going to be released. I have one here because I'm beta testing that. If you have if you buy the tabor, you are going to get a system where you can attach a very powerful graphics card. Otherwise, the CPU, it's a dual core, which means that you use only the one core until the AmigaOS 4 gets support for the rest of the cores. But until this happens, it's like having a Samantha 460 power wise for the CPU. The Samantha 460 has a full FPU, and the Tabor doesn't have a full FPU, and that is a problem for the applications that are not able to be recompiled, applications and games. I think, if I'm not wrong, in the last AmiWest there was a very good presentation from Eli Yahu, who did a presentation of the 1222, the Tabor, and how it works, and has all the information there. So if you haven't seen that, you can take a good idea of how it works from that review. I will not continue playing these games, and I will go and play a game from Super NES, Nintendo, okay, Super Nintendo, since we mentioned that earlier, which is also based on Christmas, Daze for Christmas, that's the name of the game. I think it was Daze Before Christmas, sorry. I think it was the best and most known Christmas game for Super Nintendo. To be honest, I never had a Super Nintendo before, and right now with the X5000, it's the emulator works pretty good, and it's a chance for me to visit some of these games. Just SLD Snake, have in your mind that the speed of the X5000 is the best speed that you are going to get from the hardware right now, from the Amiga ones, okay, and you are going to be able to play all the games on any of these emulators that I showed so far in 50 or 60 frames per second. For example, this is running on 60 frames per second, but the Vice for Commodore 64, it's running at top for 50 frames per second, and you are not going to have issues on speed with all this stuff. Of course, that's not the situation with Tabor. Okay. So based on what you want to do, the hardware serves you quite well for the X5000. But yeah, the full system for the X5000 is quite big, the cost. Okay, let's continue and press start. As you can see, the joystick on the USB is working just fine. Only days before Christmas, Santa slept in his house. An evil plot has brewing, cooked up by awful laws. The cold and evil snowman scared all the evil elves away. Timekeeper stole plants from Santa's house that day. But for the vicious laws, this wasn't bad enough. I'm really gonna show them, I'm gonna play rough. So we have some poetry here. SLT Snake says, thanks for the info. That multi-core support you mentioned will be a new era. That will be pretty good when it is going to be released. That will be interesting. He tore the presents open and on them cast a spell. That's when Santa woke up. Something wasn't well. All his elves had vanished, his presents also gone, and threats, oh my god, I pressed the button, So Andy, must be Santa, pick presents all the way to face the foes so bravely and make it through the day. Go beat the evil bosses who's lurking in the dark, find his sleigh and reindeer, set out to make his mark. Find every stolen present that was unjustly craved, for every kid on the earth, Christmas must be saved. SLD Snake says, I want to revisit that SNES. There are some patches for a virtual MSU1 chip, something like a SNES CD, 16 4-bit, 44 kHz music and videos. You mean all this stuff are for the old good Super NES? For the hardware? Merry Christmas, SLD Snake. Thank you for being here. Have a lovely days. Take care, man. This is such an elaborate story for a platformer. Yeah, it is, level on. Let's see how it goes. Stage 1. I don't know if the sound is good. Please tell me. It is too loud? So with one button we have jump, and the second button doesn't do. Okay, if you press down, you can see here. Okay. A nice fireplace here. I like the movement of Santa, it's very, very well done. So you have to find all the elves and all the presents. See if I miss something. Stage 1 finished. SLD Snake says, yes, the MSU1 chip ROMs are available for emulators and some flash cards for the real hardware. Nice. Very nice. Let it snow. Thank you. a snowman throws us his head. That's interesting concept. Oh my god. Yeah, that's the place where you fall down from the cliff and you finish the stage. Ice cave. I think I have the one of the yeah. Let me restart the game because one of my buttons are not the right one. And that's going to be the last game that I'm going to show you today. Restart. If we go to options and I want jump and throw, yes, now we are right. All right. Now we can throw some snowballs, if I'm not wrong. No. We throw this magic wind, probably. When you get all this coffee, you are becoming a bad Santa and you can't get any of the presents. Stage 2. Now it's going to be much easier with these snowmen that throws you their head. Now that I can throw some icy winds to them. Thank you. So right here we have our reindeer, and there is a frozen column of water in front of it, and it doesn't let it go. So Santa throws some fires that melts the frozen wall. That was a leap of faith, as I was not able to see anything.
Oh my god! Oh, oh no!
So everyone, that's my stream. It comes to an end, unfortunately. If I continue, I will play all day games with Santa, since it is Christmas Eve today. But I would like to thank you all for being here. Thank you for joining my stream. And also, I would like to thank all my supporters, because they donate to me and they help me create all these streams, and also create the open source applications that I'm doing for AmigaOS 3 and AmigaOS 4. I'd like to thank the AmigaPulse supporters, who is Daniel Gentlica, T. Livelord, and Roman Kagin, and all of my supporters. If you would like to support me, what I'm doing, you can go to my page at Ko-fi, which is Ko-fi/Walkero, and I would like to mention that 50% every month of my donations, of the donations that my supporters give me, are going to other Amiga projects, so that to support the developers of other Amiga projects to continue to do what they are doing. The last time we donated at the developer of an application for AmigaOS 4, which is a spreadsheet application called Ignition. He's doing a lot of work in there, and I find his work quite well done. So I would like I'd like to help him with some donation. So remember, if you donate to me, you donate to other Amiga projects as well. So that's something I would like to mention to you. And thank you for being here. Merry Christmas to everyone. Thank you, Amiga Gamer, Aris Amiga, JMA 80. Thank you for being here, Levelord, SLD Snake, and everyone in the stream. Have a great time with your family these days. Take some rest. If you don't work, take care. And see you next week, which is going to be New York's Eve. So, New York's, no, New Year's Eve, New York's. Oh my God. So, we are going to have fun then as well. Take care, and thank you very much for being here. Bye-bye.